Are you correcting me on comedy terminology?
She's a crazy person on a power trip. Probably that second one. So I gave her the pillow. What? Was she blonde? No. No. Wait, hold on a second. This is not your show. It would have helped her. Okay, this got real confusing. It would not have explained her stupidity, because that is an old stereotype that has been outdated for quite some time. Well, now I'm starting to believe it. Your first impression on the rest of the school. Okay, you're star Karen. Alright, I just fell like a crescendo, it was like a big joke, and that changed it. So my point was that this woman, who can have whatever hair color you want her to have in your head, surgery if it makes the joke better for you. I don't really care. You want to name her? Do you need to know she has kids? I don't care, okay? This person, regardless of gender...
Because we give people driver's licenses when they're 16, and we just let them keep them. For decades. Without another road test. You know how dangerous that shit is? I don't remember anything I learned when I was 16. If we had to do trigonometry to start our cars, how many of us would take the bus? Exactly, and that's who I was behind. Some guy who had no idea what to do. Because... I'm sorry, what was that?
Not
Heather.
Not Heather?
Heather. Oh, Heather would... know how to do trigonometry. Okay. Was there a moment in your head where you were like, these 200 strangers need to know that Heather is good at math? Like, were you worried that you were just like, you know, I don't think they know that Heather is good at trigonometry. And I'm going to interrupt this comic's closing fucking joke so we can let the world know that Heather knows trigonometry. From the fucking cheap seats. I'm so glad you paid half price to interrupt the show. I really appreciate that. Here's a great idea. The next time you're worried, a little bit insecure about your friend Heather's math knowledge, shut the fuck up. No one else cares.
And 52 police cars were surrounding the hotel. There wasn't a moment in my head where I was like, this is probably gonna work out great.
Oh, the police are just having a party. Ain't no party like the police party, because the police party don't stop.
Because you can't call the police. Keep going. We weren't allowed back in the hotel. That was how I had time to count the police cars. So I was talking to one of the reporters that was out there. That's also a sign that things have not gone well at your hotel. That there are reporters there at 1:30 in the morning. And police cars. That's why I said also, thanks for paying attention to the first part of the joke. Did the rest of you forget about the police cars? Because I mentioned them twice. And he was like, they might not know about the police cars. So I'm going to make sure everybody knows about the police cars. Because I can't follow three sentences at a time. I'm gonna be up here for an hour. You're gonna get real lost pretty soon. So. Alright. So there are 52 police cars. We're all on the same page now? Good. So I'm talking to one of the reporters. Don't forget, there were reporters.
What'd you say?
I got in trouble.
You got in trouble?
Yeah.
For what? Oh, so you loudly told us that you got in trouble for being loud? You don't seem to learn, sir.
here's the best way to not get in trouble for being loud. Shut the fuck up, and then won't be in trouble anymore.
You are more important to the show than we are. A lot of people come to a comedy show, they don't realize that. They have this just closed off, impress me energy. Just, you fuckers better be funny. Okay. What'd you say? No one's trying that, except for you just now. What the fuck is that? No one's gonna heckle. But you heckled to do it. Fucking stop it. That was the least self-aware thing. That was like a guy on a unicycle in a bowler hat being like, people in Portland are weird. Like, that was...
Is the book inappropriate for high school age children? And I said, no, it's a book about my high school experience. And she said, was there any sexual content in it? And I said, no, it's a book about my high school experience. And by the way, whoever said that they hope there's sexual content about high school children, you might want to learn when to speak and when not to.
Jacksonville, Florida, which if you don't know where that is in South Georgia. So, yeah. You cheer? Don't cheer until you hear the joke. So, this is not a moment you're going to be proud of. You still cheer? Who's cheering for Jacksonville? Now? It's like, yeah. Is that the only thing you know how to say?
South Georgia, baby.
What?
South Georgia. Yeah.
Okay, you know it's actually in Florida, right?
It's still South Georgia.
What?
It's still South Georgia.
It's still South Georgia. Yeah, that was the joke that I told. Okay, you may not have heard it because you were too busy going, So. Hell yeah. Okay, so you're from Jacksonville.
Yeah.
Okay, do you live here now?
Yeah.
Yeah, because you like Jacksonville that much. You wised up. Okay, but you still want to yell out for it in the middle of a comedy show.
Because
you're like, Jacksonville, that's where my parents fucked! Like, that's... You have nothing to do with it. Unless you did, and that's really creepy. So, alright, we're gonna move on to me. So, go ahead. That's the plan from the beginning. So, there was... You can't say go ahead and then cut in front of me. You can't wave me forward and then keep driving, sir. Wait on the highway. Wait on the fucking off ramp, okay? Alright, we're good. That's enough. I know where you're from now. I didn't ask, but now I know. And I'm gonna. Where did you grow up? You wait, where did you grow up?
Texas?
Then you kept that to yourself. That's weird. So. What a weird thing to do at a comedy show, though.
What'd you yell?
Weird.
No, I think those are two different things. What did you yell? You yelled, don't heckle? I think you might not understand the word. Everybody quiet! Don't yell out. I'm doing the thing you shouldn't do. Were you the one that said Kitty Hawk? What?
Is it real? It's not real.
Okay, I know that like there's a two drink minimum, but like that doesn't mean before the show also. You said you're stoned for the first time. This is not what pot does. Stop it. This is what an old person thinks that pot does. Pot doesn't make you yell stuff. That's not pot. You did meth. You did meth. And I'm guessing guessing it was not for the first time.
And I'm looking around that plane going, holy shit. I would rather snakes. Get these motherfucking tossies off my motherfucking plane. Did you just yell joke time? Are you confused how this normally works? Did you figure out that after the pause, after the setup, then the punchline, were you excited at that point? I think I cracked the code. Here's the best way to have a joke happen. Don't fucking interrupt it. You yell out joke time, the next words out of my mouth aren't gonna matter because everybody else is gonna be like, what the fuck was that? What did he just say? I think he just said joke time. Yeah, it's been joke time for 45 fucking minutes. Where's he been?
And so what I want to do is I've been talking at you the whole show. And now I want to give you a chance to participate.
We're
some
not
of you
in
tried
circle.
To fucking wait. What did you yell already?
We're not allowed to hackle.
You said you're not allowed to hackle. That's not what the word is. Funny, because my hackles are up right now. Hackle is a word like it's like a part of a dog. You're from the East Coast, you say hackle. I'm from New York, motherfucker. No, we don't. Are you correcting me on comedy terminology? What do you do for a living? Nothing? That would have been my guess. So,
thanks for watching my videos on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. If you're watching this on Instagram, share it in your story. If you're on Facebook, kick in a couple of stars. Facebook stars is how creators on Facebook earn a living. And if you're on YouTube, throw in a comment or a like. If you'd like to see videos like this before anybody else, make sure to join my Patreon. Patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. I'm not touring right now, but I am performing live at the Nowhere Comedy Club. All digital shows, nowherecomedyclub.com. And catch my live stream 4 days a week, free on my YouTube and my Facebook. If you want to find out when I'm back on the road and you're in the States, text Steve to 484848. And if you're in Canada, text Steve to 393939. And thanks for watching.